Welcome to the demonstration video of the Preciosa project. Preciosa ran from 2008 to 2010 and led to the development of the privacy enforcing runtime architecture called PERA. PERA is a middleware for privacy aware data management in intelligent transportation systems or ITS. PERA manages information from sensors, communication nodes and other data sources. Every data item is coupled with a privacy policy which defines privacy requirements for processing and transmitting the data. PERA evaluates requests and policies in order to control the information flow in the system and ensure policy compliant data processing and transmission. The PERA consists of a policy enforcement layer which evaluates and enforces policy compliant processing of data items between distributed nodes, and an integrity protection layer which ensures that only valid PERA instances can directly access any data. This video presents our final prototype based on Java and OSGI. The PERA currently runs on two ordinary laptops but was designed to be integrated within ITS nodes. Our use case demonstrates the information exchange between a vehicle node on the left side and an ITS service provider on the right side, for example a traffic management center for traffic control or fleet management. In our case, the vehicle transmits floating car data or FCD records to the backend server, where a PERA instance stores these FCD records in an encrypted database together with their attached privacy policies. ITS applications running on the backend can request access to FCD records for different purposes, for example to visualize the current traffic state on a map. Let's have a look at the vehicle node. On the screen, we see the current position of our vehicle on a map. The vehicle is moving on the streets of Berlin, constantly sending out data to the backend server. On the upper side of the screen, we see the privacy policy configuration window. Privacy policies are abstracted with a slider, which allows to choose between different privacy protection levels ranging from none to high. For each level, we couple corresponding privacy policies to newly created data. Depending on the current settings, services are permitted to process personal data or not. On the privacy protection level none, the processing is not restricted at all. By clicking the policy details button, the corresponding privacy policy is displayed. Selecting the level none, we see only one rule which allows any kind of processing and communication. When the privacy protection level is set to low, a use case specific privacy policy is activated that restricts which entities are permitted to access the data and for which purpose. By selecting the medium level, we can further limit the amount of data sent to the server. At the level high, we send very reduced data to the server. In addition, this data can only be processed by the selected entity traffic state application. We can also directly modify the privacy configuration of the running applications, which again affects the privacy level. So when I disable the traffic tracking, the privacy level switches to high. Let's have a look at the backend node. The ITS service provider periodically receives FCD records containing information about traffic state, license plate and cargo. All received FCD records and their coupled privacy policies are securely stored by the service provider's PERA instance. On the backend node, we run two applications. The first one is a traffic state application that processes information about traffic density in order to generate traffic jam alerts. If the driver sets the protection level to medium or high, the traffic state application cannot access the exact position of a vehicle, but only retrieve aggregated information about the region. In this case, we only retrieve information of a single vehicle, but in actual ITS applications, we could define that FCD records can only be considered if aggregated with a minimum number of other vehicle locations. As we saw before, by configuring privacy policies, drivers control how the position and the traffic state of their vehicle can be processed by applications. If we remove the permission for the traffic state application in the vehicle, the traffic state of the region disappears in the backend application. The second application on the backend is a traffic tracking application, which is designed for fleet management and freight control. The application uses more vehicle details such as license plate, exact position, vehicle type and cargo information. Again, vehicles can control what information is available to this application by choosing more or less restrictive privacy policies. If the privacy setting of the vehicle is set to high, the icon on the map disappears. Let's have a look at the internal privacy processing of the PERA. We start the PERA with an additional component that analyzes and visualizes the internal communication between core components. After requesting some sensor data, we can see two queries that both succeed. The first query requests a reduced FCD record containing position and timestamp, while the second query requests the full FCD record, also containing license plate, vehicle type and cargo. If we set the privacy protection level to medium and run the same queries again, we only see the result of the first query. The second query fails because access to the full FCD record is denied. If we set the protection level to high, both queries fail and we get no data at all. The PERA measures the integrity of the running system using a Trusted Platform Module, or TPM. On startup, signatures of all OSGI bundles are verified. Only if all signatures match the trusted system state, the TPM provides access to encryption keys and allows decryption of the database. If the system's integrity is violated, access to the keys is refused and the content of the database stays protected. To demonstrate this, a malicious modified PCM bundle, one of the core components, is loaded. All other bundles start as usual, but the database and therefore the sensitive information is not available. For more information, visit our webpage at www.preciosa-project.org. The Preciosa project is part of the eSafety Initiative, the Information Society and Media Initiative, and has been funded in the 7th Framework Program of the European Commission.